Bonjour, my lovely friends, and welcome back to the Zelts for One or Two. It purely depends on how generous you feel like being with your sugars. Now, today we are making the most classical French desserts, the French macaron. Now, if you've never made macaron before, they can be trickier than trying not to fall in love with your best friend on a whimsical sheep herding adventure on Brokeback Mountain. Oh, the tension was riveting. Now you just saw me put all my dry ingredients through the fine sifter. This is what creates the iconic smooth and shiny exterior and allows your macaron to showboat his handsomeness like a strutting peacock. We continue on by whipping our egg whites to firm peaks. Now, if you don't have a stand mixer or a hand mixer to whip your egg whites, and you're doing it by hand, just go ahead and bump up your prep time by about 6 or 7 hours should do. This should give you enough time to whip them up, as well as rub a generous portion of icy hot all over your shoulders. Fun fact for you here, you can use any festive color you want for your macaron recipe. Just make sure that you are using gel color, not liquid color, or you will risk throwing off the consistency of your batter. You will know when you've reached the proper consistency because your batter will mimic the way macaron batter would fall off of a bowl scraper. Oh look, there's my powerful baking shoulder. It's so nice. What I was doing there was popping any air bubbles that might be trying to escape from the roof of the macaron after giving it a stiff rapid tapping on the table. This helps eliminate any imperfections that might be coming through the surface. Once we get our Spartan army of macarons free of any imperfections into the oven, we can go on to starting our filling. The filling that I am making is kind of a pumpkin-y pie type of buttercream, but this is where you can use your imagination and let your creativity take you anywhere. It's like a silly little dance. You fill your macarons however you see fit. It's your delight. Oh, look at these perfect gentlemen coming out of the oven. They've been on their best behavior. You pop this lovely filling in between a couple of these perfect shells, and you're talking about entering a world sweeter than staring into Dr. Phil's sensitive baby doe eyes as that soft southern voice talks to you about your self-destructive behaviors. Enjoy the recipe and have fun in the kitchen, everyone.